Well, thanks everybody for joining us today. This is a real pleasure for us and a new beginning for Calgary. You know, I tell this story often, so I hope you don't mind. For those that have heard it before, I still hope it has meaning. You know, when I first arrived back in Calgary after a number of years away, it was a year after the flood, and I was out riding my bike on Bow Crescent, which is in Bowness. And as I was driving down the street on my bike, I looked to my right, and there was an elderly couple that were standing arm in arm, and I could see that the gentleman was crying. So I slowed down because I wanted to find out a little bit what was going on. I was anticipating what was happening here was that this was a family that lived on the street for many years, and they were standing in front of an empty lot where their house had been washed away by the flood. And I was imagining that their hopes, dreams, and aspirations had been gone like that in the snap of fingers. And as I progressed down that street, there were great big huge red hearts on that street, thanking people in this room, thanking other Calgarians for helping them put their lives back together. It was a remarkable scene when you can see what that looked like. And when you think about Calgary, that was a defining moment in our history. We responded together, and the images of Calgary were broadcast around the world of a city coming together to help their community and their neighbors put their lives back together. And then a year later, we were the fastest growing city in North America. 40,000 people were moving to our city. Now, these weren't just new Calgarians, these were new Canadians. 55% of the people that were moving to Calgary were new to this city. They came from all over the world. They were experiencing why they left their hometowns, because they wanted a new life and they wanted to make it here in Calgary. So as a city, we were adjusting to a new future, welcoming people from around the world and adjusting to what that life would look like, a new, diverse, and inclusive community. And when you think about it, that we were no longer the redneck cowboy town that our reputation was in the past. And just a few years later now, we find ourselves in an economic downturn, the likes of which we haven't seen in over 30 years. So when you talk about the ability to be able to be resilient and respond to the ups and downs the community has and has to deal with, we've had our fair share, I can tell you that. And in this day and age, you know, when we saw the flood, we could see the water. We understood what the forces were, what were in play. But today, the impact of the economic downturn on families and communities is not so easily apparent. The consequences will be long-lasting, and they're complex. And we're finding our way in battling the economic downturn using the same skills and abilities that we used in fighting the flood. And you know what was remarkable in all the midst of all of this? We sent a bunch of folks up to Fort McMurray, hundreds of people that left their duties, left their families, and went up to Fort McMurray to help that community fight a massive fire. I'm very, very proud of the way in which our organization and this community responds to adversity. You know, Katja quoted Jane Jacobs, and I'm going to do the same, but it's a different quote. Jane Jacobs talked about Calgary, and she said that Calgary was, in her lifetime, the only city in North America to go from adolescence to adulthood. She was explaining that we were a young city. We were like young teenagers. We were a rowdy bunch of teenagers here in this city, and we were finding our wings, and we were growing into a young, youthful city that would be completely different than what we were in the past. And the characteristics of a maturing city is a growing awareness of what sustainability and resiliency really looks like, and understanding how we're going to use those characteristics and understand the concepts of those characteristics that would make us a better city in the future. You know, we use various phrases to describe our changing generations. I'm going to date myself here. We're boomers and yuppies and Gen X and Gen Y. And I was lying awake last night because I get a little nervous when I have to speak in public. And I was thinking about maybe Forrest Gump, I hope I'm not dating myself here, was the first generation of a first person of a resilient generation. And his quote was, "Life is like a box of chocolates. You never know what's inside." And that's kind of like what running a city is all about. You know, he was able to adapt to the circumstances that were facing him. He never lost sight of his hopes, dreams, and aspirations, regardless of the challenges that were facing him. But many of box of chocolates come with cheat sheets inside them. And today we're people from around the world living in communities that were sharing the same box of chocolates. And we can't afford the risk of biting into chocolates we don't like or that we don't know what's inside. So we need a cheat sheet that goes inside our box of chocolates that explains what's inside a resilient world. We need to learn together, share our knowledge, and celebrate our successes. Today, we're joining a generation of resilient cities endowed by the Rockefeller Foundation that represents a new way of thinking about our common future. We're sharing our knowledge and understanding of what to expect inside our box of chocolates, which represents a new world of ours. I'm honored to announce today that my friend and colleague, Brad Stevens, has been named our Chief Resilience Officer. You know, this isn't just a corporate role, but this is a strategic position of influence within our community. No one is better equipped to lead our city in building relationships within this family of resilient communities and in forging a new future for the City of Calgary. Brad has been responsible for leading our adaptation to change. You know, I've asked him to take on a variety of different experiments, and those experiments oftentimes are fraught with danger, right? Nobody knows what the end of that experiment's going to be look like. So we've asked him to take on another experiment about joining the Resilient City community. You know, Brad has had to adapt to 40,000 people moving to the city and then respond to an economic downturn. So his assignments have been varied and many. So I'm delighted that he's accepted this assignment, and I want to thank him dearly. And I also want to thank the Rockefeller Foundation for welcoming Calgary into its family of resilient cities. This is truly an honor for the city, and I didn't look at it as a competition because we did have to go through quite a rigorous process to get selected, and I was so proud of the team that put everything together, and many of the people that were part of that team are responsible for today's event. But my God, I'm so glad that we were able to make it. I'm going to end with a quick story, and then I'm going to actually ask Brad to come up. Maybe the mayor, by the time I finish the story, I see he's out in the corridor. So maybe what I'll do is ask the mayor to come up, and then we'll ask Brad to come up at the end of it. But I'm going to end on a quick story, and then I'm going to conclude. My favorite comedian is John Panette. Does anybody know John Panette? He died recently. He was a robust man. He was always fighting his weight. And he didn't like the diets that he was put on, and he was always on, seemed to be on one diet or another, but he was on a gluten-free diet, and he said this: "I don't know what gluten is, but it must be delicious." And so, to conclude on that, I'm not really sure what resiliency is all about, but I know it's essential to our future as a community and our future in this world. And I know that by partnering and sharing our knowledge with the resilience communities and our partners, that we're going to be better off in the future. So today is the first day of a new beginning for the City of Calgary, and you're all part of kicking it all off. Thank you so much for everybody, and I'll ask the mayor to come up.